how to make puffy cloud paint. I love to paint. And today, I'm going to show you how to make puffy cloud paint so you can play too. The first step into making puffy cloud paint is to get half a cup of flour and pour it into a bigger bowl. Then you should take half a cup of glue. Then you need 4 cups of shaving cream.
There, that's about 4 cups.
Then you mix all that together. Important tip, do not overmix. You want the shaving cream to stay light and fluffy, so don't mix super fast or super hard.
Feels light and fluffy, just the right consistency. Feels kind of like a marshmallow.
It feels like a cloud.
If it's not fluffy enough, then you might want to add some more shaving cream. The best thing to do is add a little bit at a time. Once it's mixed, this is going to be your white paint. Put your white paint in each of the little bowls. These will be your different color paints. You mix the food coloring into your white cloud to make it a color. Add more drops to make it darker and less drops to make it lighter. Really stir it good so all of the darker color gets mixed in. But don't mix it too much so it gets not puffy anymore. I think that's about good. Want it to get about this color.
And once you make all your colors, you paint. Once you're ready to paint, you want a piece of poster board or cardboard. Because since cloud paint is really wet, regular paper will just soak it up and will rip. So you want a thicker piece of material. You can use sponges, brushes, or even spoons. I'm gonna use some white first to make the little clouds at the side of my rainbow. Cloud paint is kind of hard to work with, so you might want to dab it instead of brushing it like you would with regular paint. You want it to be as puffy as possible. You should try to layer over layer so it gets more of that little puffy, cloudy texture. I guess cloud paint, when it dries, it feels like your hands could be walking on a cloud because it feels so good. It feels fluffy and so squishy.
Make sure it's puffy so it looks like a puffy rainbow, not just the puffy clouds.
I'm using a spoon now because using a spoon, you can drag it out more. You can always spread it a little bit. It's really great to use your fingers because it's okay to get messy using cloud paint. That's half the fun of it.
How to make marbleized paper.
We made this cool paper. Isn't it beautiful? We're gonna show you how to make one so you can play too. First, you need a baking tray, and then you need some shaving cream.
Just get regular shaving cream that's white. Make sure it doesn't have any aloe vera and no gel cream.
Fill the tray with the shaving cream.
I got it.
Once the tray is filled with shaving cream, you have to smooth out the top.
You can use your hands or a ruler or even a mixing spoon.
You really want the top very smooth so that when you press down your card, it's not bumpy or anything or there's clumps on it. Then you're gonna add your food coloring. I've decided that I'm going to use red first. Think about colors that you'd like to see together. And then drop the food coloring close together.
Then you use a toothpick to marble the top.
Marble is a sort of funny word because it doesn't have anything to do with little balls of glass. When you marble something in art, it means you gently mix a dark color into a light color.
You gently use a toothpick to mix the color in. Once the colors are mixed, you're ready to put on your paper.
Don't use regular paper because it will get too wet with the shaving cream. Use a note card or any other heavy paper.
Press it right on top of the shaving cream, right on the colorful spot you want. When you're pressing it in, you're putting the ink on the card. Don't press it to the bottom, just press it lightly on top of the shaving cream.
Then peel it gently out. and then scrape the shaving cream off of the card.
Whoa. What's left behind is the beautiful pattern of marbled food coloring.
This is so cool.
Finally, when you're done, it's gonna look like this.
And that's how you make marbleized paper.
How to make a snowman garland. Deck the halls with snowman garlands. Fa la 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 la.
We made snowman garlands and we're gonna show you how to make one so you can play too. A garland is a type of party decoration that you can hang up like a rope.
To make a snowman garland, you'll need some paper plates.
This is going to be our face. First, you have to punch holes into the plate. They're supposed to be like this, so then when you put the string between, it will hang like this. Next, we're gonna make the snowman's face.
You can use markers, pipe cleaners, pom-poms, googly eyes, and cut up paper. I'm gonna start with the eyes. You'll need some glue. I chose two different googly eyes to make it look silly. Now I'm gonna make a nose. I'm gonna use orange to make the nose look like a carrot. Now I'm going to give him a smiley face.
I'm gonna use crayon for my smile.
I'm gonna use a pipe cleaner and some pom-poms to make earmuffs.
I'm adding little rosy cheeks to my snowman.
You wanna make your snowman's face big so you could see it farther away.
Once you're done with your snowman face, you can put a piece of string in the holes that we punched earlier.
I'm slithering the string piece inside my two punch holes.
Now I'm doing that the same. And when it comes out, they'll both be on the same string.
Once you've made a lot of faces, you're ready to string them up.
Make sure you talk to an adult to figure out the best place to hang your garland.
And that's how you make a snowman garland. How to make a Halloween bat.
Woo! I'm so excited to go trick-or-treating.
Me too. Mama, I want to go trick-or-treating.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, but the moon is out. It's
and
full.
And the ghosts are out.
Oh. It's the perfect Halloween day.
Okay, well, only because it's Halloween.
Woo!
Let's go! Whee!
We made our own Halloween bat.
We're gonna show you how to make one so you can play too. Here's how you make a Halloween bat.
First you need toilet paper tubes.
Then you'll need some paper of any color.
You want the paper to be about the size of your toilet paper tubes.
You're gonna wrap the paper around the toilet paper tube. Then you're gonna tape the edges of the paper together so it will stay wrapped around.
Then you're gonna draw on your face.
I'm gonna draw eyes, fangs, and a mouth.
I'm gonna draw eyes and just fangs. There, I made the face for the bat.
Don't put your face too close to the top because you're gonna need space for the ears. The next step is to add your wings.
You're gonna need another piece of paper.
Then you're gonna kinda make a fan.
You're gonna fold on one side and then fold on the other.
And then just keep doing that.
Just keep folding back and forth until you get a fan.
Once you have your fan, it will look like this.
There, I made one.
Then you fold your fan in half. Then you're gonna tape the inside of the wing together.
There, I have a wing.
So do I.
Then your wings get taped onto your bat.
Then you add another wing to the other side. These bats might be really good for a Halloween party.
I made my other wing.
I got my other wing on and it's balancing.
One last step, the ears. Just press down the middle of your toilet paper tube.
That's the best part about Halloween. You just make stuff up.
And that's how you make a Halloween bat.
Ooh!
How to make sand art.
We're making beautiful sand art today.
We're gonna show you how to do it so you can play too.
First, you need a plastic bag, a piece of sidewalk chalk, and some salt.
Pour about a cup of salt into your bag.
Now you'll need some chalk.
Pick the color you want and put that piece of chalk in the bag too.
Then you zip it back up
and then rub. Rub the salt and chalk together. The salt is scratchy on the chalk.
It causes the chalk to break apart in teeny tiny pieces. Those little pieces mixed with the salt becomes your sand.
The more you rub, the darker the color of the sand would be.
Once the salt is the color you want, you can pour it into a bowl.
These are some sands we made earlier, and we're gonna show you how to pour it.
First, you'll need a recycled water bottle. It can be glass or plastic. Next, you'll need a funnel. You put the funnel on the top of the water bottle so you can pour the sand into the funnel and it comes into the water bottle.
Now, you're gonna need some small cups to scoop the sand up. Need about a half of these little cups.
You can choose whatever color you want. You can do it in a pattern, or you can make it random.
My turn.
Now I'm adding blue. I'm gonna add a little bit more blue because I want it to make a whole layer. Now I'm gonna put some green in. Last but not least, some pink. I'll fill about half a cup of it. I'm adding a little bit more so it looks better.
Now I'm gonna tilt it to make it even.
You just keep on layering the colors you want. And then at the end, you'll have a colorful sand masterpiece.
There we go. We'll just shake it a little bit to make it a little even.
Can we add a little bit more orange?
Yeah. Why don't we add some pink?
Okay.
This is about to be full.
Now you need to put the cap on.
And that's how you make our masterpiece of sand art.
How to make jiggly tea jellies.
You want some dinner, baby jellyfish?
Yeah, let's go get them. I'm gonna get some fish.
I'm gonna get some octopus.
We made jiggly wiggly jellyfish.
And we're gonna show you how to make one so you can play too.
First, we're gonna make our papa jellyfish.
First, you need a bowl.
Ask an adult to poke a hole in the bowl so you can thread your yarn through. The reason why you're doing this is so that you can hang your jellyfish up on the wall or just play with it. And then pull it out almost all the way.
When you're done with that, you're going to tape it so that it can stay.
Tape it on the inside so no one can see. And so that you can hang it like this.
After that, what you're going to do is you're going to take markers or crayons and color the bowl with it so that your jellyfish can have some decoration. You can use any colors you want. I'm going to use a red, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a pink crayon and I'm going to color on top of the red marker so that it's very colorful and bright.
I think the cool thing about jellyfish is they get tentacles and so they can sting you.
And the last color I'm gonna add is green. You can decorate it any way you want to, like she decorated it with squiggles and lines, and I just decorated it and colored it all the way. You can draw hearts, you can draw smiley faces, you can draw anything you want on it to just make it look pretty. And so what you're gonna do is you're gonna take two googly eyeballs, and you're gonna use about this much glue, and then you're gonna stick it on the circle that we drew on the plate. The last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use this dark green to draw a smiley face.
Jellyfish don't really have eyes, but they are cute. When you're done with all that decorating, you've got only half of your jellyfish done.
Now we're gonna move on to the tentacles. You can use ribbon. You could use cut up newspaper strips. You can use cut up magazine strips. You can really use anything you want. Like here we have ribbon and shred paper.
And we also have yarn.
I'm going to put a blue piece. And you can use glue or tape to stick it on, but if you want it to dry faster, you should use tape. Once you've got your tentacles on, you've made your jiggly wiggly Papa Jellyfish.
Don't they look awesome?
Ew, it's so jiggly!
Cause jellyfish don't have bones.
Come on, Jellies.